across America, people are preparing, going to staggering lengths to protect their families from their greatest fears. In Texas, one prepper is planning a home defense strategy designed to catch intruders off guard.
Yes!
And in Tennessee, another is escaping.
Pull the door shut.
To an invisible bug out. They are prepping for Armageddon.
Daddy, there's a fire!
The apocalypse.
Go, go!
The end of the world as we know it. They are Doomsday Preppers.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
For the past 6 years, Robert, his wife Wendy, and their daughter Riley have been living a quiet life on 10 acres outside of Dallas, Texas.
I've moved my family outside of Dallas to hopefully protect and prevent any sort of harm.
Sometimes you get nervous.
He's funny like his brother.
Oh, really?
Once we found out we were pregnant, we decided to move away from the city. Right. We wanted a place where we could provide unique things, the outdoors, fishing, horseback riding, swimming.
Providing a safe environment for his family is Robert's top priority.
Is that good? All right. Aw, thank you.
That fell off.
Much of his focus on safety comes from his time in the military.
I served in the United States Air Force for 4 years. I was trained as a firefighter and paramedic. Because of my training in the Air Force, I am always alert and trying to think of the worst case scenario of an environment. What would happen if an emergency occurred right now? What would I do? What steps would I take to protect myself and my family? My instinct tells me now that that danger could be coming towards me and my family. Everything that we are accustomed to today could go away tomorrow.
I'm preparing for martial law.
Any sort of threat towards the government on the United States soil could lead to an enactment of martial law. We all have examples of what lawlessness can do to cities. Los Angeles riots. Inevitably, Dallas will look like New Orleans after Katrina. Once lawlessness takes over, there will be people that will do whatever it takes to steal, to hurt, to harm. I want to do whatever it takes to prepare so that those individuals cannot harm me or my family. Under martial law, anything can happen. They can reduce our access to fuel. They can reduce our access to power. So it's important that my family is able to survive without the aid or benefit of anyone outside our property. Power is essential. My pride and joy are my solar panels. What we've done is we've created a solar panel system that are mobile. And I have enough stored power to supply my home with electricity without recharging for a week. And I don't have to pay anybody a cent. Prepping has become so addictive. I got my first bucket of food and it took off from there.
Rob has enough food to feed his family for 2 years. He makes his own bullets so he won't run out. And he has a stockpile of weapons.
Firearms are important at any time, but especially after martial law is declared. I need to protect my home. I need to protect my property. I need to protect my family. Practice to me is part of my prep. In my arsenal, I have several 22 pistols, 357 Magnum, Smith & Wesson 500. It's a 50 caliber handgun. I have an M4, a couple of Uzis, a Bushmaster 50 caliber. If you can't stop them with this, you probably need a tank. Wow.
Guns and ammunition are just one component in Robert's home defense strategy. In the event of martial law, he's planning something that no intruder could predict.
To protect my family from marauders, I'm building the ultimate booby trap system.
I live in Tennessee, 20 miles south of Nashville, in a fairly large suburban area. I live with my wife, Marcia, and my daughter, Melissa, and my son, Mike. Mike is very smart, got a great intellect. My daughter, Melissa, is just like me, she loves the outdoors.
Let's get some basil and some parsley.
I'll get the strawberries.
Oh, yeah.
What are we making?
Well, this stuff. I could not imagine being without my family. I could not imagine them being hurt in any way. Just, it breaks me up. I will not stand to see that happen. I'm preparing for the coming economic collapse and the chaos that will follow.
There's one.
The American government today is messing stuff up. We are looking at a failing economy. Now imagine when people wake up in the morning and their dollar is worth nothing. Imagine going down to the grocery store, but they're not gonna accept that dollar. You think you have money in the bank? You think you have a savings for your retirement? When the economy collapses, it will be worthless. It's just gonna be numbers on a paper. And I'll be doggone if I'm gonna sit back and let it happen to me.
I built the rain catchment system. So if the grid goes down, I'll never go thirsty.
I've got 8 months worth of food stored. So when the shit hits the fan, we will not go hungry.
I have a 30-acre bug-out property where my family can escape the chaos of the city and hide from the marauders.
I have over 12,000 rounds of ammunition because I will go to any length to keep my family safe. Some people may say that I'm obsessed with prepping, but really, I'm obsessed with keeping my family safe. I don't see a paranoia there. I see wisdom.
For the last year, Greg has been working from home as a computer programmer. Instead of commuting, he uses the time to increase his food supply with a 95-square-foot garden, raising rabbits, and canning.
It's not gonna be telling people about all the canning, because if they find out and the economy does collapse, then we won't have enough to supply for ourselves.
Melissa's quite the little prepper. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. But my wife is not the prepper like I am. She understands what I'm doing.
We need to rinse these beans out.
And she's very supportive.
11.5 million people in the United States are unemployed. And for the first time in history, America's national credit rating was downgraded, which Greg believes could lead to a countrywide food shortage. So he's asked Marcia to help increase their canned food supply from 8 months to 1 year.
2 years is about the max that they'll give you on most stuff. And I think they do that as a safety precaution because there are people that have had stuff that's, you know, 10, 15 years, and it's just fine. It's not gonna hurt you and make you sick, something like that. And you realize that when there is a collapse, the dollar will be worth nothing. You won't be able to buy food.
And we'll become a target.
Yep, exactly.
But even with all of his preps securely stowed away in his suburban home, The crux of Greg's plan to save his family is complete relocation.
All right.
TJ, come on.
Come on, Bubs. Let's go to the bug out.
Greg's bug out is located an hour away from his home and is removed from an isolated road, which has no street lamps or gas stations for over 400 miles. Greg is training Mike how to patrol their property, but he fears what would happen if the two of them were outnumbered in an attack.
You got the regular bad guy, and I'm less worried about him because I can really fight back. But when you've got some sort of forces, that's the bigger threat because they got backup and they got bigger guns.
So he's building his most ambitious prep yet, one that will give him a strategic advantage where he'll be hidden away in plain sight.
Perfect view. When I need to bug out, I'll bug up.
In a rural area outside of Dallas, Texas, former Air Force firefighter Robert is prepping for martial law and civil unrest.
A lot of people think that preparation is silly, but quite frankly, I would rather be wrong and alive than dead in an emergency situation. We need to reserve what we have and protect our families. We need to be suspect of anyone that comes near our property.
Robert is strategizing how to secure the perimeter of his home and is collaborating with his neighbor and fellow prepper, Gary, a Vietnam veteran.
This is going to be the best way for us to kind of survey the land.
They are conducting an aerial reconnaissance of their adjacent properties using Robert's private airplane.
Doors locked, seatbelt on, here we go.
From the air, you're able to see things and scope out an environment that you just can't see from the ground.
Between them, Robert and Gary have 20 acres of land to fortify.
Guard to my second pond. That's where we're going to be susceptible to something.
Robert is taking inspiration for his perimeter defense system from medieval fortifications, which often used a series of physical impediments to stop intruders prior to any engagement in combat.
Yeah, well, I think we know that one corridor from the trails in between you and I.
Okay.
That's vulnerable.
That's going to be our most vulnerable points.
Yeah.
That's what we need to focus on when we get back on the ground.
They plan to encircle their property with layers of defensive booby traps.
This is going to be a huge undertaking to protect our families and everything that we have.
While in flight, Robert and Gary identified a trail which connects their properties as a potential weak spot where an intruder could gain direct access to one of their homes. It is there they want to begin testing a non-lethal ambush device.
This is basically an experiment. This is an early warning trap.
The first ring of defense will be a trip line alarm built with some common household items. And they think the noise that is created will alert them to a potential breach of their property.
The way it's designed is when the trap is tripped, it's going to hit the firing pin, which is then going to fire off the shotgun shell.
This should be a good place for a perimeter, right?
This looks good.
I saw the design for this online. This will be for noise and early warning only. Putting the firing pin in, and I'm setting the trap. You want to try it?
Sure.
I'll walk through it?
Yeah.
I think I put it together right.
Ah!
Looks like firing pin didn't twist it.
I think it's you. You're just not walking through there, correct?
Well, you do it then, trap walker.
Mm. That blows. Could be our mechanism.
That's professionally designed.
The traps that we built, it just seems like there wasn't enough force, but there was enough force to push the shell away from it. So as the pin went through, the shell was, you know, moving as well. Thought it would work, but I guess not. So back to the drawing board.
In preparation for a national financial catastrophe, Tennessee prepper Greg has food, water, and ammo stored at his suburban home. But he fears that eventually, urban looters will leave city limits and raid small towns like his. So he's planning to spend most of Doomsday in an undisclosed location, hidden away among the trees.
I'm building this invisible treehouse. It's gonna have mirrored paneling on it so it reflects the forest around it. It's gonna be at least 12 feet up into the canopy, so it's above the eye level. It will have a one-way mirrored window in it so we can see down and see what's happening. It's gonna be a place where my family can hide if there's a potential threat, and I can store my food in there as well.
But the project is too big to do alone. So he's hired his contractor friend, Steve.
Our purpose here today is to figure out how I can even get further hid if someone does come on the property. And so my idea is to get a treehouse that's camouflaged up in the canopy there using mirrors. Think about it. During the seasons, we go from green to grays and browns. The mirrors will reflect that. And you, if somebody's walking around here, they're going to see the sky and the trees.
When Greg first called me, I didn't realize the extent of his prepping.
About eight by eight, maybe?
Yeah, but if that's what Greg wants, that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna call my crew when I get it done.
Got 9'9" between trees. Got 91 inches.
This is something that is going up in the air, and so it's a little bit different than being able to start with a nice foundation on the ground. Gravity's working against you. So we got the posts on the blocks, and we've got the stringers around the edges, and it's starting to look pretty good. The next phase now is getting the joists into the floor level so that we can start getting the decking up there.
10-1 3/4.
Greg, his daughter Melissa, and the crew are cutting lengths of wood that will be arranged in a parallel series known as joists. The same construction application is used in home building to support a floor or ceiling.
This is going to be interesting seeing how we get the decking up there, because we're talking about throwing up pieces of plywood.
But veiling the treehouse to mimic its surroundings may not be as simple as Greg thought.
Let's get it on and see how it works. I really got to make sure that this reflects correctly and doesn't give itself away.
In Texas, Robert and his friend Gary are both concerned that Doomsday will bring looters to their property. So they plan to head off any invasion with an elaborate system of booby traps. But after a test of his simple warning alarm failed, he's decided his design needs to be bigger, louder, and brighter.
I was completely disappointed yesterday with the rat trap shotgun shell audible alert. So I designed something with two flares, piece of wood, trip wire.
This will still be non-lethal. Someone crosses over, it'll trip the flares, and obviously it's gonna just make a huge sound, and it's gonna have a lot of smoke.
All right.
You can barely see it, but I got the trip wire that runs all the way down
to this tree right here.
You may want to plug your ears because it gets a little loud. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Right there.
I impressed myself with these flares. They pulled easily, and the flares shot right into the hole. There was a big cloud of smoke, the red phosphorus light. I just couldn't have asked for anything better.
Dude, I finally did something right. Yes, it worked.
A small crew is hard at work, helping Tennessee prepper Greg and his daughter Melissa construct an invisible treehouse 12 feet above ground on his bug-out property.
When the economy fails, anybody that could find the trail could be a potential threat. I need to be able to hide my family, and that's why I'm building an invisible treehouse.
The above-ground platform has been planted, but Greg needs solid proof that the structure won't collapse under the weight of his family of four.
Every step of the process, I need to stop and kind of check things and make sure it's secure. All right, so the floor looks good and solid.
Yes, 3/4 inch flooring, which you'd normally use in a residential house.
Yep. This treehouse has got to be safe. I want my family safe.
So, yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Yeah. It's looking pretty good. Nice and sturdy.
With the structure nearing completion, Greg and Melissa are getting ready to add the layer of invisibility.
It's got a good reflection quality.
Greg wants to do more than blend into the surrounding location. He wants to disappear. So he's opted to employ the adaptive camouflage method, which allows an object to imitate its actively changing environment.
The seasons change, so you need that camouflage to change with it. What I want to do is get it along the walls, go down around the edges so I can pull it up underneath.
He's hoping the reflective mirror paneling he purchased online will yield the same results as a top secret material being developed by the military that bends light waves around a target, making it invisible.
How's that reflection?
Hopefully that'll work. Let's get it on and see how it works.
As one half of the crew adheres the mirror paneling, the other half begins work on installing an acrylic two-way mirror that is shatterproof and will allow Greg to see out without letting anyone see in.
Perfect view.
How's it coming?
All right, what do you think?
Looking nice. I'm gonna miss it.
Yeah.
When I go off to college.
I'm sure gonna miss you while we're finishing up.
I'm gonna miss you too, Dad. I like helping you put it up and stuff.
And when you get back here, we'll go up and drill you a sniper hole.
All right, sounds good. I'm going off to college and I'm leaving my dad kind of by himself. It's gonna suck leaving him behind. But I don't really want him to think about that because he might get a little teary.
I still have my wife and son with me, so I won't be alone. But my daughter, I feel like I'm losing my prepper buddy.
Okay, you ready?
All right.
Can I grab your stuff?
Hey, give me a goodbye hug and stuff.
It was nice working with you, Dad.
All right. Love you.
Love me, too.
Bye.
Good
day.
I miss her being by my side already.
But life in the treehouse could be more dangerous for Greg's wife than he was expecting.
Oh, God, I don't want to do it.
In Texas, Robert is building a second ring of his perimeter defense system, a series of fall traps designed to stop intruders in their tracks.
The booby traps are designed to keep people outside of the perimeter, but if they breach it, I've got something in mind that will blow them away.
That'll mess you up.
Well, the ones they used in Nam were a lot bigger than this. They had like, they would have them like 2-3 feet wide by almost 6-7 feet. And you could actually catch two people in the thing.
Wow.
Nasty stuff.
With all the materials that these traps are taking, you know, $5, $6, maybe $10 per trap. So unbelievably effective and very cost efficient.
It'll work.
Well, let's hope we never have to deploy them.
I hope we never have to use them either. But I want them built. I want them tested. That way, we've got time to do it now while things are still good. We'll dig some holes. We'll bury them. We'll test it out.
Yeah.
Robert's first level of defense, the tripwire alarm, serves as an audible alert, so Robert is aware his perimeter has been breached.
About a foot more.
It's also designed to intimidate anyone from proceeding further. So he wants the fall trap to stop the trespassers who aren't as easily deterred.
Idea is someone is walking along. They have already bypassed any tripwires. This will be the next line of defense.
Yeah.
When they step in, boom, they'll drop to the spikes. I got something to test it with.
Yeah? What you got?
Oh, my goodness.
This will simulate a leg. Any last goodbyes?
Adios, my friend.
All right.
Whoa. Whoa.
Wow. If they get past this, that means you and I are going to be shooting at them.
Satisfied with the results of the fall trap, they are ready to test their next layer of defense, a ploy that will not just maim, but kill. But an unpredictable force catches him off guard.
Hey, I gotta go pick up Riley. The school sent out emails. They're closing the schools early because of the storm. Because of tornado watch until 7 o'clock, so the schools are closing and then the program so that may be canceled. So I'm gonna go get her.
Get her.
Bye.
Hurry back, please.
Every single day of the year, Southeast Texas is at risk for violent tornadoes. The worst ones often strike in the fall and winter, and sometimes sweep in one after another.
The whole metroplex or this area is under tornado watch until around 7 o'clock.
Roads are flooding right now. My worst fear is that something might happen to them before they get home. I'm not getting a signal.
If economic disaster strikes, Greg's top priority is to keep his family safely hidden in a custom-designed invisible treehouse he's building on his 30-acre bug-out property.
Got it?
The quality of this peel-and-stick mirror stuff looks really good. I'm still concerned about, are we gonna catch, like, little nail divots or knots that might show up?
Kind of a metal roller or something, we might be able to just flatten those down anyway.
I really gotta make sure that this reflects correctly and doesn't give itself away.
But like many preppers, Greg believes that having only one plan is simply not enough.
I'm also going to build a spider hole for defense.
Spider holes were used extensively by the Viet Cong during the Vietnam War. It is a camouflaged ground-level observation post designed for an individual to stay hidden before making a stealthy attack.
From there, I will be able to watch what's happening with the periscope.
The periscope is going to be a great tool when I get into the spider hole because I can get eyes on that trail before anybody else can see me.
Perfect. If somebody gets to this point, the spider hole, I will stop them here. I will shoot them here. I will make sure the threat goes no further.
The spider hole uses the surrounding vegetation as camouflage. And the treehouse that uses adaptive camouflage is nearly complete.
You guys ready to go take a look? It's time.
Let's go look.
Come on, Mike. Come on, dogs.
Oh, I see it. It's right
there. Oh, that's awesome. That's amazing.
Oh, my goodness. This is the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Texas lies in Tornado Alley, and right now, former military man Robert is facing something he never prepared for. His family is missing, and there's a tornado on the way.
I do everything I can to prepare, to make sure that they're safe and secure here. But until they get here, it's out of my control. Hey, where are you? Here it comes. So, obviously, hurry as quickly as you can. I love you. I'm glad you're home okay. We gotta get in a storm shelter.
I was a nervous wreck. I had no idea where they were. They should have been at the house a lot sooner than they were.
You guys hear that?
Yeah.
It's pretty bad outside.
My family is my top priority in life. There would be no reason to exist without them.
Shit. What was that? It's gonna be okay, all right? It's gonna be okay. That was probably just some lightning or something. It's okay, though. That's why we're here, all right?
The shelter, it's probably one of the best preps that I've ever taken. And it ensures that we're protected. We will come out alive.
For Robert, natural disasters reinforce his motivations for prepping. And after safely weathering the storm, he's ready to test his final layer of defense. One that Robert believes will require the use of deadly force.
Basically, what I have is a bullet-resistant product that will stop bullets coming towards me, but it allows me to return fire against anybody that might be attacking.
The material is made with a hardened outer layer and a softer inner layer filled with liquid resin. A fired bullet disintegrates upon impacting with the hardened layer. The energy is then absorbed by the gel-like interior layer.
The bullets haven't penetrated the bulletproof material. The dummy is safe. Now the real test is to see if I can shoot out of it.
When shooting through the material, the pressure of the bullet causes the hardened layer to explode, allowing the bullet to pass freely.
The bulletproof material did exactly what it was designed to do. It blocked the bullets and it allowed me to fire back. I fired off 5 rounds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's something I definitely want to put all around the perimeter of my house.
But the bulletproof material is just one of 2 components Robert wants to use in his final layer of defense.
If somehow they got through the warning flares or the traps, this is my idea for like the last line of defense. This will blow them in half or scare them away, but it'll definitely take care of our problem, okay?
Robert is disguising small containers of an explosive compound. The ammonium-based powder can only be triggered by a high-velocity bullet.
The horse protein buckets, we've got them all over the property. People won't think anything different. Okay. But we got Tannerite in them. I set up the dummies within a 10-foot radius. The Tannerite explosion will take anything out.
If it doesn't knock them down, they're not gonna hear anything for a while.
I think it's gonna do it.
Robert and Gary are ready for an explosive test in the final ring of their perimeter defense strategy. So suburban Tennessee prepper Greg has been building his biggest prep yet. A camouflage treehouse that will become a mirror image of the dense forest that surrounds it. After days of construction, he's ready to show his wife and son where they'll be taking shelter in the event of an economic collapse.
Oh, I see it.
Right. Oh, that's awesome.
That's
really
amazing. Oh, my goodness.
That's where you get to hide.
This is the coolest thing I've ever seen.
The physical construction was challenging, but for Greg's wife, Marcia, the biggest obstacle still lies ahead.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. What do you think?
It's pretty high. I'm kind of a little bit nervous.
Yeah. This particular ladder will not be here.
I am afraid of heights, and I have been probably since I was about 11 years old.
My worry is that she will not want to go up, or if I get her up, she may not want to come back down. Well, here's the ladder.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
And I'll hook it up just like this.
I think I'd rather use the big ladder.
Yeah, but we can't have this ladder here. I know. Anybody could come along and crawl up in the treehouse.
That's pretty high.
But that's what's going to keep you safe. I know Marcia is afraid of heights, but she's going to have to get over that fear, because when the economy fails and we're out here hiding the food, I would much rather her be alive and up in the tree than dead.
Oh, my God, I'm scared.
Just try.
This is scary. I thought it was going to be up against a tree.
Just get a hold of it.
Make it straight.
Oh, I don't want to do this. It's not, it's going to fall.
No, it's not. I've already done it.
Oh, my
God. It's not falling.
Oh, God, I don't want to do it.
You don't even want to get on it and try it like a swing?
I don't want to do it.
You sure?
Yeah.
If I can't get her in there, it was pretty much a waste of time. I'm not going to leave any of my family behind.
Robert and his neighbor, Gary, are readying to stop any and all invaders with a multi-layer perimeter defense plan. For the final level, they've developed a deadly and explosive trap. Buckets filled with 1 pound of explosives. Now, he'll test the power of a chain reaction with a single shot.
Look at the dummy. It's gone. Totally blew it apart. Look at the bucket.
Yeah?
It's gone. That's this.
That stuff works. I love it.
Survival can be an ugly beast, but you do whatever you need to protect your family, your supplies, and your freedoms.
What do you think, Gary? I mean, it did what it's supposed to do.
Good shot, man. Sorry, young lady or young man.
Martial law is inevitable. Therefore, I must be prepared for that day. We've got the flares. We've got the traps. The bulletproof material stopped the bullets, and it allowed me to fire back at the intruder. As a final layer of defense, we've got the Tannerite. Nobody's going to make it on my property. As it stands right now, you're not coming here, so don't even try.
In preparation for an economic collapse,
I'm up.
Greg has a 30-acre bug-out property where he plans to seamlessly hide his family among the woods in an adaptive camouflage invisible treehouse. But his wife's extreme fear of heights resulted in a change of plans.
Oh, God, I don't want to do it.
This way?
I don't want to do it.
Nothing behind it. Once I get on it, it just swings all over the place.
It needs to be stabilized at the ground.
What I did was run a runner across the two posts on the one side there. And then I ran a 2x12 up from the bottom. That way, when that ladder come down, it would give her a secure feeling to get up.
If Marcia can't overcome her crippling fear of heights, Greg believes her chances of survival will be slim to none. So he's arranged for a simulated ambush that he hopes will help her conquer her phobia.
There's somebody on the property.
What am I doing?
It's about the trees. Go. Go, 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 go. Okay. They're coming right now, baby. You gotta get up this thing. You gotta get up right now. You got it? Go, Marcy. Go, Marcy. You gotta go. Okay, so I'm right here. Can you pull that door open? All right. All right. Okay, just go ahead. Go, take your time. I'm right here. Okay, there you go. It's all right?
Yeah.
Mike, you gotta go. Just look up, see your mom, okay?
Gotcha. Yeah?
See, I can do that one.
Yeah, there you go. Mike, hold the ladder.
Shut the door.
Pull the door shut, Mike. Everything's okay. You can calm down.
Oh, jeez.
How long did it take before you caught it?
Actually, till now.
That's a heck of a treehouse.
It turned out to be a good practice run, and we found out that Marcia could make it up the ladder.
When it's a matter of life and death, you have to buck up and try to overcome everything.
I'm proud of her.
When the economy crashes, no one will be able to find us or our food. You can see what's coming down the pike. America, wake up, because if you're not prepared, you're gonna be sorry. Don't come knocking at my door. Robert and Greg, the experts, practical preppers, have assessed your preps. Rob, your proven low-tech perimeter defense traps provide a time-tested layer of security for your family. Additionally, your food and water storage is a good start, but we recommend you store seed as a means of resupply.
I appreciate the evaluation. I feel that we learn from each other, and it's just another step in our prep.
Greg, having a remote, undisclosed bug-out location is wise, and the invisible treehouse is a highly creative prep. However, if it is discovered, you will be trapped inside with no way out.
I understand what they're saying, but they'll have to get past me and the spider hole to get to my family.
While martial law has been declared in the past, it has not happened at a national level in the modern age. It has only been used on small scales to regain order during extreme crises, such as Hurricane Katrina. While hyperinflation and severe economic depression have occurred, it has only happened in countries that were on the edge of complete political breakdown. Most economists agree that the United States does not face this threat and has sufficient fail-safes in place to avert such a disaster.